Hello, this is Arthur. I'm a web designer based in Brazil, and I'm going to talk a little bit about how to center an element vertically using CSS. My cousin is also into web development, and he sent me an email this morning asking about this, and I thought it could be something useful for other people as well. So for this, I'm using this web app called CSS Desk. It's very simple, it's intuitive, and it supports CSS 3, which is awesome. And if you want to use it, you can go ahead to cssdesk.com. And if you don't want to use it, that's okay too. You can use TextMate, Coda, or any other text editor you want. So I'll start off with this basic markup here. We have a parent element called wrapper, and we have the actual element we want to center. And let's suppose this is for a coming soon page. Okay, so first of all, I'm going to show two different ways of accomplishing the same thing. The first one, in my opinion, is the easiest way, and but it's not as good as the second one. So you might want to watch both. So I have some basic CSS written here. It's nothing special. You don't have to worry about that. Let's get started. The first thing you want to do is you want to set your wrapper as absolute. So you just write position absolute here. That's it. And then you have to move it 50% down. So top 50%. Okay, now we have to play with the actual element we have to center. To do that, first of all, I'm going to give it a background color so you can see what's going on. Background, I think this is kind of bluish. All right, so we're all set. Okay, so now let me tell you. This is the reason why this method isn't very good or very flexible. You have to specify the actual size of your element. So this is not very good, but we have to do it. If we want to use this technique, let's just say it's 400 pixels wide and 200 pixels high. Okay, the final step to center it is to move the element a little bit up. So to do that, we set the top margin top to negative 100 pixels. Okay, and it's done. We moved it to the exact middle of the page. But you might want to center it completely. So all you have to do is set the right and left margins to auto. So margin left auto and margin right auto. Okay, oh, and this doesn't work because you have to say that the wrapper is 100 pixels, 100% wide. All right, looking good. This is it. It works fine. Okay, so the technique I just showed you works, but it's not very flexible, and I'm going to show you why. Suppose you have some text you want to add. And you see, you can't really change the size of your element without digging into your CSS files. So if you want to change the content later on, it might be kind of bothering. So this is why it's not very good. Good news is there is a better way of doing it. However, this second method doesn't play well with old browsers, as you might have expected. So you have to figure out which solution is the best one for your website. Okay, so let's go ahead and get started here. Let's go back to the basic CSS and markup we had before. I think this was it. And okay, so the first thing we got to do here is we have to create a pseudo element before our wrapper. And we do this by writing wrapper before. And this is the reason why it's called a pseudo element. And also the reason why it doesn't work with old browsers such as Internet Explorer 6 or 7, for example. And what you want to do here is you want to say that content is nothing, and you want to set the height of the pseudo element to 100%. Okay, and now the next thing, you display it as an inline block element, and you say that vertical align equals middle. And the reason why we use this is obviously because we want our element to be vertically centered. And just a quick reminder, this property only works with inline block elements. And you can see here that we just created a big pseudo element before our wrapper, and it takes 100% of the screen. And to fix that, we have to add something to our centered element. It's very simple. We have to do the same thing. We have to display it as an inline object, and we have to say that vertical align is middle. And now the magic happens. Our element is centered. If that's all you want, you're done here. Of course, you might want to do something else. You might want to center it horizontally. If you want to do that, it's very simple. You have to add text align center to your wrapper element. And the reason why this works is because inline block elements, they behave sort of like text. So text align would work for them as well. And this is it. It's centered. You can add text here, and it's going to work. So if you want, you can also add some background to the centered element. Let's add the same color we used before. Looking good. Let's add some text. And you can see that it continues to work. Okay, so in this case, I think you might want to limit how wide your element is. So I'll set width equals 400 pixels. This way it looks better. And you can add more and more text. And later on, you won't have to touch your CSS files again. All right, so this is the second method. It's not very hard, actually. It's harder to understand, but it's pretty easy as well. Of course, it doesn't work with old browsers, so you have to see which one is the best method for your website. And I guess this is it. I hope this was somewhat helpful. And I know there might be other ways of doing the same thing. So if you want to suggest or ask anything, you can comment below. And also, I'll post the links to the generated pieces of code, and you can download them and play a little bit with them. All right, so I'll see you later.